Oh, okay, I know what's going on. Casting this on you now. Oh, I just got a pop-up saying warning slow connection, so some of my talk will be breaked up. Okay. Oh, this is being broadcasted on you now. My computer lighting source just went out. Okay. So, I have not made a video in, like, a whole entire month. Not that anyone cares, but it's been maybe, like, more than a month. I don't know. So there's a lot of shit that's going on that I need to talk about. I'm not happy right now, and I've been talking to myself for a good hour or something like that, like, or more than an hour. I've been talking to myself all day. So first I'll briefly touch on my first date. Yes, it went well. It was at, like, a smaller restaurant. There was one moment where things kind of took a turn. Like, this one old lady was behind me staring at me. Like, I turned around and she was staring at me and stuff. The date was with a different guy than what I had originally expected to be, because that guy that I was talking about in the last video, he actually... pretty much, I can say that he's gone. Like, he just vanished out of clear blue. Then, like, he just kind of, like, vanished out of clear blue. I haven't heard from him at all. So, I went on a date with a different guy than, what I expected. And, yeah, the first date went well overall. Both of my parents were there. Because I'm meeting a new guy off the internet and stuff, and, yeah, it went pretty well. At times, I kind of, like, had dead moments where I didn't really know what to say to him and stuff. This guy was, like, in his 30s. I don't want to say exactly how old, because it's none of y'all business. Not really. I just want to keep that... I mean, the exact age, let's just keep that private, but he was in his 30s. I had my first date. I had it. That's all that matters. Okay. So, there's a lot of shit going on in my life right now. I'm not happy at all. I'm just, like, life sucks right now. Okay. So, anyhow, I'm about, ready to go on my second date. And this time it's with someone new. Okay. And here's where all these problems have arise. This newer guy is even older. And, what really interests me about this other newer guy, well, he's not really newer. I've known him as long as the other guy. It's just that, he's newer in respect that I just kind of, like, just mentioned it to my mom and everything, blah, blah, blah. You know, I'm anticipating to go out with him maybe, like, next week, okay? And him and I are both interested in rock music, and, I'm more sexually attracted to him than the other guy. On some levels, and, you know, it just, I feel a connection and everything, and I really, you know, he's introduced me to a new band already called In This Moment and stuff like that, and I really starting to like him, you know, more than anyone else off of Tinder. Anyone else that I've ever dealt with on Tinder so far. So, of course... my dad makes me say something to my mom. Why is that? Because my dad's driving me. It's all because my dad's behind the fucking wheel, okay? It's all because my dad's driving me. And he feels that if something bad happens, that he's fucking liable for it. Okay, I'm not talking about liable in the legal sense because I'm not a minor anymore. I'm going on 20 years old already, okay? But he's liable in the sense that if something happens, that, like, his wife... would be pissed off at him, blah, blah, blah. So he told me that straight up, he refuses to take me unless I talk to my mom about every single man that I have in my life. Which is really fucked up. It's really fucking messed up, man. I fucking hate it, okay? And I'm still a virgin, yes. Of course I'm still a virgin. I'll get into why in just a second. You know, but anyhow, this is temporary, this whole thing about having to tell my mom about every single man in my life. Because of the, it's all because of the fact that I can't drive. And guess what? When I go in the fucking DMV to take that fucking written test, there's that much more burden on me. There's that much more of a monkey on my back. It's, you know, my ass is that much more on the line. Because basically, I have to pass this written DMV test for my fucking freedom. Like, I ain't just going in there taking the test like it's some fucking math test. No, this is a test for my fucking freedom, okay? I'm basically testing out to get my fucking freedom in life. Because my mom's so, like, she puts a dark cloud over my head. She makes this so fucking painful. And it's so hard dating people. It was really hard even getting the first date. This has been so hard. That basically, the stakes on that test for me are very high. Because basically, I'm testing out for my fucking freedom here, okay? Like, I'm doing that test just to earn my fucking freedom. And I've brought up Uber and Lyft today, seeing if I could do that for my dating things. Because I know I'm not gonna learn how to drive overnight. And basically, I just kind of like, when I discussed it with my dad, I said it's one of those things that you and I would need to try, and then I can tell my mom about, because right now my mom would not be okay with me taking Uber just because of the fact that it's a stranger, and you know what she's gonna do? She's gonna go out looking for me, you know, and she's gonna basically, you know, she's gonna think I ran away or something if I take Uber now, you know, and it would, I know the things that she would do, so it's like, I can't do Uber or Lyft now. I don't even, the thing is, I told my dad, like, hey, one day, let's just test it out, see what it's like, and then I can tell my mom about it, and nothing bad happened, that I was safe, da-da-da, you know? So, that, I mean, my mom won't even let me do that right now, so I'm all, like, fucking dependent on my dad driving me. And it's bullshit. It's bullshit. It is. It's bullshit. Okay? It's bullshit. It really is. It's fucking bullshit. Because I'm going on fucking 20 years old already. But this is just temporary because I'm planning on learning how to drive. But that ain't gonna happen overnight. Even after I pass the written DMV test. Because I get my permit and no one learns how to parallel park overnight. No one learns how to fucking drive on the freeway overnight or none of that shit. Nobody learned that shit overnight. This is gonna be a problem for, it could be a problem for, like, we're talking, like, a year. This could be a problem well in the next year, and it's a big problem, okay? It's a big fucking problem because, like, this is a fucking problem, man, because I'm getting stressed out. The whole family's getting stressed out. I'm getting stressed out. It's all because my dad wants me to tell my mom everything with my dating life, because he thinks that if he drives me behind my mom's back, that he's liable, and then he's saying, oh, I refuse to take you now. All because of his wife. What he's afraid of what she's going to do to him if I get hurt or I get in trouble. Then it's all on him, you know? And I told him, yeah, I get it. I know. I get it. I get it. I get where he's coming from, you know? I get it. You know, it's really fucked up situation. I don't have my freedom. So, it's really fucked up. It's fucked up. And it's so fucked up that it's disgusting. It really disgusts me. I'm deeply disgusted with this. I am not happy about this. I have not had a positive experience of dating with my mom being involved. It has not been a positive experience. It's been a very fucking negative experience. And frankly, I want it to end. I want to lose my virginity. I want it to end. Because after I lose my virginity, I'm home free after that. I don't need to continue having sex. I don't need to continue looking. I'm fucking done for, like, a long fucking time. You know? Because, you know, to be honest, you know, it's like, my man wanted to have sex with me again after first time. It's not like I'm going to tell you, like, this and that about this and that. And I gotta, like, you know, but I'm just saying, it's been such an emotionally challenging experience for me to get there. And dealing with a virgin is, dealing with being a virgin is an emotional challenge in itself. And it's been equally as emotionally challenging just to get there because of the parental bullshit and all that. With my mom mostly. It's mostly perpetuated by my mom. So I think I'm gonna have a very bitter feeling about that. And I think it's gonna take me, I don't think I'm gonna get over it either. I think it's gonna take me a very long time to get over it. Because I have one of those moms where you can't talk about sex to her. She'll say, oh yeah, my daughter can talk to me about sex. Yeah, right. No, I can't. No, I can't. I can't, mom. No, I can't. And my dad even admitted that even though I know about condoms and, like, you know, birth control and you know, tracking my cycle and ovulation, I know about all that shit. I know all this stuff because I've done months and months and years, and I have done so much research. I have done so much to actively protect myself. You know, I'm very aware, you know, of what I can be aware of being a virgin. I'm very aware of what I can to prepare myself for the first time to not get pregnant and all that jazz. You know, but my mom's not even willing to talk about that because she just doesn't want to deal with it. So she brushed me off like I don't matter. Like, oh yeah, I don't care. It's like, oh yeah, you have an appetite for, you know, you have sexual desires, you have an appetite, you're hungry, da-da-da, you want to suck some dick, I don't care, you know, that kind of thing. Like, she just doesn't care. And she doesn't want to talk about it because she doesn't open herself up to talk about it. Unapproachable. I have one of those moms that you can't talk about sex with. I can talk about sex with my dad, which sounds creepy, but it's true. He's the only parent I could talk about this stuff with. I can't talk about it with my mom. I have one of those parents. Okay? Admit, I have one of those parents. My mom. Unapproachable about sex. Can't talk about sex openly with her. Okay? I have one of those moms. So that is a fucking, that is a fucking headache to deal with. And I'm end up being forced to have to divulge information to her about guys. Because my dad's driving me. It's all because my dad's driving me. So he thinks he's responsible for me. So that's why I have to tell my mom shit. And I don't like it. I don't appreciate it. Fucking hate it. Okay? I don't like this. Because my mom's opinionated. She come at me with, like, it's like somebody trying to shove a religion down your throat. You know, she come at me with these opinions and these comments, and sometimes she, like, tries to tease me and shit. But sometimes she's very opinionated. She not only come at me, she come at my dad, too. Okay? You know, she's very opinionated. You know what happened? I told her the other day, I think it was yesterday. I told her yesterday about the next guy that I want to go out with. You know, and this is the guy I was talking about that introduced me to a new band that I felt more of a connection with than anybody off of Tinder, da da da, okay. So, I'm talking about the guy that I have a lot in common with. Okay, I told you he's a bit older than the other guy. Okay? So, here we go again. You know, I'm having to tell my mom. I didn't even verbalize it. I gave her a fucking note. I wrote a fucking note because I was so afraid to open up my mouth. I just wrote a fucking note. And I said, here you go. I just wrote a fucking note. I didn't even want to. I was just too, like, you know, I was just too, like, really, like, you know, I was just too afraid to say it out loud. I couldn't do it. I had to give her a note. And at first she, you know what she does? At first she's, like, kind of like, you know, she was, like, mentioning something about, benefits and how I, like, benefits, like, money benefits. She, like, totally changed the subject. She changed the subject. And then she started laughing about it. And then she started comparing him to some other older guys that we know of and started laughing about it, laughing it off. So I assumed, oh, okay, you're cool with it. You know, and she's like, oh, yeah, you don't have to be afraid to tell me. Okay. She's like, oh, yeah, I'm not gonna, you don't see me reacting, la, la, la. She's like, it's okay to tell me. You can tell me it wasn't such a big deal, la, la, la. Okay. She's acting like she's pretty much acting like she's cool with it for the most part, although she did show some signs of kind of like, you know, although she did show some signs of kind of like giving me a hard time. But it was tolerable. It was something I could deal with, you know. I didn't walk away from that situation being too angry. So, she goes in her room. She comes out 10 minutes later. This guy's a pedophile! At 10 minutes later. 10 minutes later. She's like, giving me, she's like, all these, show me all these opinions. She's like saying, I'm breaking your lives. You're stressing. 10 minutes later. 10 minutes later. She is, man. She is, like, really upset. 10 minutes later, she's like, well, at first she told me, I'm breaking out of hives again because I'm worried about you. I was like, see, that's why I didn't want to tell you because I tried to, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, I'm only telling you because my dad's making me tell you. And then she comes up to me and says, that's disgusting. What should a 50-something-year-old have to do with a 19-year-old? And he's a pedophile, and he's a pedophile, and he's a pedophile, blah, blah, blah. Like, 10 minutes later. And I can't even say that with a serious look on my face. Honestly, somebody who's a pedophile is interested in children. I'm not a child. I'm an adult. I'm going on fucking 20 years old already. And she was wrong by saying that, okay? I talked to my dad about this later today. And it's all nonsense. It's all nonsense. It's all nonsense. And she's calling him a fucking pedophile and everything, just really just ripping the whole thing, just really, you know, just like, okay? I get really angry and pissed off when I talk about this because it makes me really fucking mad, okay? I just like, don't judge somebody. You didn't even fucking need them yet. Don't judge them. It's like she's, it's like what my dad and I said today. It's like guilty. It's like you're guilty before you even prove innocent. Like, and this is, it's like, it's supposed to be like, you're innocent until proven guilty. Well, she's like going guilty, guilty, guilty already before, you know, it's like she's already judging this guy before, it's like, I don't even, so this is why I really hate. I hate it when I have to tell my mom, guys. I fucking hate it, man. I really do. I hate it. I hate it so much. I hate it so much. Really drives me to the edge of my seat. I really am tired of it. And I'm being forced to. Because my dad said he won't take me unless I the fuss up about it. And I'm 19 and a half years old. I'm going out 20 years old. just really, really, like, oh, I'm pissed off, okay? It's obvious I'm pretty pissed off. Don't worry, I don't act like this in real life. Don't worry, I'm pretty chill in real life. I'm just putting on a big show because this is a video, okay? This is a live broadcast. I'm just putting on a big show because this is a live broadcast, okay? I just want to show how I feel. I don't like this. I have it that much harder because I'm a girl also. I know some guys have it hard too, but I get more criticism. And I get looked at more like, dirty, because I'm a girl. I have to deal with it that much more. It's not fair to me. By other girls, which my mom is a girl. Well, she's a woman, but, you know, it's like I have to deal with that much more trouble in my life because of my gender. Because of my fucking gender. You know, and she's has these opinions because of my fucking gender. You know, well, maybe she had these opinions regardless of my gender, whatever, but I really think there's a lot of problems in my life because of being a female and because of all the hate and all the shit I get. I get so much shit for whatever it is. I get so much shit. Okay? And it's really hard to deal with it. Really difficult. And I really, really am, like, done with being a virgin. Like, I'm done with that shit, man. And I have these hormones. So, I mean, beyond just that, I really want to see a man naked with, you know, this. You know, it doesn't have to be that long. It's an exaggeration, honey. Okay, but I really want to see a guy naked when he's aroused. And, you know, I want to do all this stuff that I've been thinking about. And, you know, I can almost just taste it, okay? And it's like, I've been repressed. And stuff like that growing up. So these urges are kind of like, it's a little on the extreme side. Like, I want it really fucking bad. Like, I want it really bad. So, anyhow. It's like the first moment when I first admit it. Like, the first day and the day after I admit it are the worst. For my mom, guys. So basically, I'm still virgin. Let me tell you what else. I'm dependent on three guys right now. I had three guys in my life right now that I've been kind of like having some sexual dialogue with. And I'm like my heart set in on it. Like there is no one else kind of thing because my mom is just so hard to approach. And my dad sets it up for me where I have to approach my mom. I can't really do anything behind her back until I know how to drive. And now I'm gonna rush into knowing how to drive. And that ain't gonna work out good. That's gonna be a fucking disaster. You know, it's like, hello, now I'm having to rush into how to drive. It's like, now I'm being rushed in to know how to drive. It's like, now I have to rush into driving. You know, honestly, I should have fucking learned how to drive earlier. I should have fucking learned how to drive when everyone else did. I listened, you know, my parents always told me that they couldn't afford driving lessons and shit. So now I'm stuck in this situation where I have to fucking rush into driving. I have to fucking rush in to learn how to drive. And it's not fucking fair, man. It's not fucking right. It's not fucking fair. It's fucked up. It's not right. It's not right. And now I have to hurry up because of all this shit. Because all this fucking drama in my life. Like, I have to hurry up now and learn how to drive. I have to hurry up. I can just pick up the fucking pace. Not cool, man. I have to pick up the fucking pace. And that's not cool. I mean, yeah, I want to learn how to drive really bad. Because it's my freedom. I have no fucking freedom, really. It's limited. I do have freedom, but limited. Okay, limited. And I have to, like, fucking learn how to drive now. It's like, come on, hurry up! Hurry up! It's like, fuck that shit. Well, guess what? I have to fucking hurry up! Because I don't want to deal with my mom anymore. I don't want to have to tell her about guys anymore. I don't want to be in this situation anymore where I have to tell her about guys and deal with the way she reacts and deal with her opinions and have this stuff shoved down my throat and deal with the whole, like my mom are, like, kind of, like, up, you know, up neck and neck. Like, as far as, you know, me dating the, you know, me and my dating thing and, the fact that I'm dating men, she has a problem with it. We're up, like, neck and neck. Okay. Strangely, she has no problem with the one who's, like, in his 30s because he's, like, Mr. Right. He's, like, perfect. But, anyhow, my mom are, like, up neck and neck on this whole dating thing, just in general. With this whole Tinder thing, just in general, her and I are, like, up neck and neck. And the fact that, like, older guys that are even as far up in their 50s, I'd like to say, we're up neck and neck on that. Okay? We've always been up neck and neck on it. You know, I was like that when I was 13 and even before. I haven't changed. Okay, but we're like up neck and neck on this shit. We're like up neck and neck. And it's like, it gets complicated. And anyhow, my point is, well, after I have sex, I'm not going to be worried about guys anymore and everything. I'm not going to really worry about that anymore because, like, you know, that's all I ask. Because I'm so repressed, believe me. I'm so repressed to the point where I'm not, I don't care about the second time, the third time. No, I just want the first time. Like, that's how repressed I am. That's how repressed I am, guys. I'm fucking repressed as shit. You know, yeah, well, I mean, you can blame a lot of people for that. Fuck. I'm gonna see what kind of comments I have. How old are you? That's what I usually get. What happened? Okay. What happened? What the hell? Okay. I just needed a vent, because this is such a toxic situation in my life. And I understand the safety side of it. I understand she wants me to be safe, but you know how my mom handles safety? You know how my mom tries to keep me safe? You know how she handles safety? Let me tell you how she handles safety. Basically, how she handles safety is basically, you know, it's like, kind of like, she kind of like, I guess, like, tweaks it to where it's, like, reflecting on her negative experiences and stuff and that, you know, it's like, she kind of, like, just really, like, kind of, like, you know, ruins it for me, to be frank, be honest, she just ruins it for me. I mean, really. I mean, that's how she handles it. She just ruins it for me. She just takes all the fun out of it. That's how she handles safety. She takes all the fun out of it. She ruins it. She makes it something to, you know, she makes it something, you know, she makes it painful. She makes it something to, you know, she makes it something deep and dark and, you know, she makes it, you know. So, I basically stopped looking on Tinder for, I don't know, how many weeks now? Because I was busy doing stuff for driver's ed tests because I want to get in the DMV and pass that written test already. I should have done this a lot earlier. But nobody around me encouraged me. I only had letdowns from my parents telling me I couldn't have driving lessons. So that's why I pushed it this late. That's why I got pushed into being this late. And plus, I can't do schoolwork and do this simultaneously. Yeah. It's fucked up. Anyhow. I was doing that for, let's just say since my last day, I haven't looked on Tinder, so it's been, like, about a good 4 to 5 weeks, maybe, like, a month. So, I have a decision. Either I be dependent on 3 guys because of my mom being the way she is, or I look so I can, you know, stay positive and move forward. So the decision I make, obviously, is to look, even if I don't find anything else. Yeah, because, I mean, my mom got me chicken shit, you know, to admit anything, tell her anything. It's like a disaster to tell her anything. She got me, like, you know, basically, I was talking to my dad today, and I was like, you know, the way my mom raises me, it's like she's Homer, and you know how Homer chokes Bart? Now, I don't mean this literally, I mean this figuratively, it's like metaphorically. You know how Homer, like, chokes the life out of Bart on The Simpsons? He's choking Bart, you know, Homer choking Bart on The Simpsons. You watch The Simpsons, you know what I'm talking about. I think most of you know what I'm talking about, okay? I feel like that with my mom sometimes. Like, just the whole way she carries herself and everything. I feel like that. I feel that tension right there. Don't have the best relationship with my mom. I don't. You know, honestly, my mom always asks me for a hug. I give her hugs and everything. You know, it doesn't mean I have a good relationship. It doesn't mean I have the best relationship with her. No, I don't. I'm sorry, I don't. I have a better relationship with my dad. Because my mom's just not open. That openness is just not there. She's so closed-minded. She wants to see things only the way she sees. The only way she wants it. She's selfish that way. It's kind of like being selfish in a way. I don't know. My dad told me, and I know this already, that she has had really bad experiences dating guys growing up. And I don't want to say it, but she's had really bad experiences with guys and even forced sex. There you go, I said it. She's had really, some really horrible, I guess, experiences with guys abusing her and exploiting her. And she puts that all on me. She pins that all on me, okay? She puts that all on me, just... She puts all of that on me. She... No hesitation. She just... She... Puts that on me. She puts that all on me. That's why this whole dating thing is so painful for me. That's why she takes all the fun out of it. That's why it's so hard to tell her about any guy. Because my dad basically makes me, I have to, all because of the fact I can't drive. That's why, that's the root of it. That's, yeah. And my dad says she'll never get over it. And I'm like, okay, she'll never get over it, fine. But I'll never get over this either. So, nobody's getting better because I'll never get over this either. Like, she's never going to get out of that. Well, I'm never going to get over this. Oh, it's a two-way street, but she's pinning it all on me. My mom's bad experience with guys, whatever happened, she's pinning that all on me. She's putting that on me. Literally. So, to start looking for other guys on Tinder, it's going to be like moving this big rock out of the way. Because literally, that's what it is. I have this big rock in my way blocking my view. And it's like, it's going to be like moving a fucking mountain. Because I have no self-confidence after yesterday, after having a midterm. I have no self-confidence. Every time this happens, my self-confidence just gets blown out of the sand. I come out of it with low self-esteem, low self-confidence, because she pins all her negativity on top of me. And I was positive all the way up until then. She rubs her negativity on me, just kind of like feeding off of me and putting all those bad experiences that she had on me. So I can't stay positive. And then I have a low self-esteem and low self-confidence, and I can't fucking look anymore because I can't fucking, like, see a future. I can't even see my future anymore, thank you very much. I can't even see a future anymore, thank you very much. I can't even see my future of breaking my virginity, when it's gonna happen. I can't even see myself losing my virginity anymore, thank you very much. Which, I want to lose it, and it's very depressing. Not losing it, being in the, yeah, it's very depressing. So, it just depresses me even more. I'm already, like, in this situation. It just, I'm in college, I'm a virgin. I'm already, depresses me more. Bring me down even more, yeah. Yeah, you know what's really fucked up? Not only do I have to tell her about it, she goes along on these dates because she figures that I'm better off having both parents there and da-da-da. You know, and I try to tell her. I try to express my concerns, you know, but if I thought things were bad, now things would be worse. If I, like, tell her you can't go. She makes me pay for her fucking dinner. I have to pay for her. Yeah, I have to pay for my parents' dinner. Don't think that, because you're a guy and you pay for my date, that it costs me nothing. No, I have to pay for my parents eating back there. I have to pay for my mom who's eating back there. Because she's so cheap, she can't pay for it. Yeah, I have to pay for it. I have to pay for it. I mean, it's one thing if we're eating out and I have to pay for my meal. Okay, fine. But no, I'm paying for my mom to eat is... Because she has, you know, because it has to be, like, has to go. These both parents have to be there, and I have to pay for her. It would be cheaper for me to take an Uber. Dating sucks. The actual date doesn't suck, but setting up for the date and all the stuff going on in the background sucks. It makes dating suck. And to be honest with you, I'm not going to be looking for any more guys after I get my virginity broken for a long time. I at least need to know how to drive first. That's a big plus, okay? I need to be more independent before I bring any more guys in my life after I get my virginity broken because my mom is so heated. So heated. I'm basically just gonna surrender after that. Because, yes, I still have the one thing in mind that I need to get my virginity broken. I need to just move on already. But my friends told me that. And it's true, I need to move on already. Because I holding on to so much anger and so much resentment, you wouldn't believe it. I'm holding on to hatred, too, and all this shit. I'm holding on to it. I'm even holding on to hatred because it's the hatred that comes from the jealousy of seeing other people have fun. It's that type of hatred. It's not like the I hate you kind of thing, no. Okay. It's most of it's self-hatred anyways that I'm holding on to. So, I'm doing what's best for me. Meanwhile, I got my mom plotting against me. And it is. Anyhow. Let's see what's going on in the comments section. Nothing. Yeah, ever since I've been broadcasting off of my other Android phone, nothing's been happening that much, and that's okay. So anyhow, I'm flustered. It's understandable because I have one of those moms that I can't talk about sex with and I can't be open with. I have one of those moms. So, whether or not you can relate, I don't know. I mean, most experts would recommend that their parents be open with their kids. And their kids be open with them. My mom's not that way. It's starting to not matter as much. And it's starting to get, you know, it's starting to not matter as much because I'm an adult. And I'm still dealing with this. Because my dad makes me go to her because my dad's basically, you know, my dad's basically afraid to take me without me telling her because he's afraid that he's going to get in trouble if something bad happens, which is true. And he said, and he laid lying down with me, and he said, if you don't tell her, I don't take you. And that would lead me to have to do Uber or Lyft. Those are my only other options. And my mom's, it's going to be really hard for my mom to be okay with that because my mom watches over me like a hawk. And probably not in a good way. I mean, it's good and bad that she watches over me like a hawk. It's both good and bad. Well, she's not watching me like a, she's not watching me over like a hawk all the time because I'm with my dad most of the time anyways. But I'm just saying, you know, she doesn't let me go out and do stuff by myself. I've never done anything by myself. That's the way I've been raised, so. I just raised that way, so. All this stuff's really hard for me. And, it's really, like, taking a lot out of me. And it's, I'm really taking a beating, guys. I'm really taking a beating, especially from my mom. I'm taking a beating from all this emotional beating, not physical emotional, okay. And taking emotional beating from all this. So, another thing I wanted to mention is, I don't know whether or not I'm going out with this guy next week. I want to see what happens. But when I tell my mom, is this such and such time going to be okay? It's going to be another one of those, again. It's probably not going to be a very good experience. It's going to be hard to ask my mom what time is okay. Like, is this time okay? She's gonna be like, you know, she could, I don't think that it's gonna be such a big deal now because she actually knows about it. It's just the part getting her to know about it is so fucking difficult. And I don't want to deal with it in the future. I don't want to deal with it. I've had it already, man. I don't want to deal with it. Okay. I know it may sound like I'm a, I know it may sound like I'm a little too angry, like I'm gonna act out kinda angry. I know it may sound like that, but trust me, I would never cross over the line with my anger, trust me. I would never do that, okay? I know, this is probably the angriest you've ever seen me in all my videos. This is probably the angriest I've ever been, to be honest with you. I've probably never been this angry in any of my videos. I'm just really, really disgusted. Deeply disgusted. Deeply, deeply, deeply disgusted. Okay? You probably see it in my eyes that I'm really disgusted. I mean, staying safe is a big concern of mine, too, and it's a concern that we all share in this family. You know, I mean, we all highly value safety, so that, I'm going to, you know, give a break on the safety aspect of it, but just the whole way it's handled with my mom. Don't particularly appreciate everything. There's some things that my mom say that I do agree, you know, there's sometimes we do agree. It's not enough agreeing. It's mostly disagreeing. It's not enough agreeing. And all this name-calling, nitpicking, and even judging the guy I'm going out with and all this. And I hate telling him. I really think it's a sacrifice to tell her. Because I always come out of it worse than I do coming in it. Always come out of it worse. Because by then, my self-confidence is ruined. I mean, emotionally, I'm in a ruin by the time I get done. It's, like, really hard. So, I'm limiting the amount of guys I have in my life right now, basically, because of the fact that I can't drive. Not dependent. Can't do anything behind your back, because all the other stuff is going to have to be, you know, private, secret. Because, I mean, I can't deal with this any longer. I can deal with this sort of ignoring. This is like, I already know this is a little drill. I know what's said and done. I ain't saying shit anymore if I don't have to. I'm only doing it right now because I have to. I don't have a choice. It's because I don't drive. That's the only reason why I'm saying stuff, but when I can drive, believe me, I ain't going through this anymore. I tell my dad everything. My dad and I have a very close connection. I tell my dad everything. My dad and I, you know, my dad's very open. So if I have a question or concern, I always go to my dad. My dad knows me. Anyhow, my dad's the parent that I can talk to about all this and have an open conversation. It's like, let's have an open conversation with our kids and talk about this openly. I can do that with my dad. My mom. My mom won't do that. My mom always just like, my mom won't do that. Won't do that. Non-negotiable. She will not do that. You can tell I'm overloaded. You can tell I'm really like, I have this dark cloud over me, hey, you know. Oh, when I do have sex, I won't tell her. I won't say nothing. Because, like, you know, basically me and my guy are going to talk about that. That's going to be about it. I'm going to come home like it was any other night. Shit. It probably won't go down like that. I'll probably have to say something like all the other things. I mean, I don't want to say anything if I don't have to, but I'll probably end up having to say something. And the night before is probably going to be the biggest night of chaos. There's probably going to be so much chaos that night before I have sex with my mom. It's probably gonna be really chaotic. But my mom always forces me into telling her things because he's driving me. So he always forces me into telling her things. So I'll probably be ultimately forced into telling her that too. And she's probably going to try it. She's probably going to be delayed for like a couple of days. Because she's probably going to hold me back and never let me go. And then let me go like days later. And it's going to be like, it's going to be another hell. This isn't the last of it. There's more to be dealt with. Unless I have sex next year, then it might be possible that I might know how to drive by then, but I don't know. It's all a mess. It's really fucked up, to be honest with you. I mean, if I can hang out with the guy by myself, I can be with him by myself, and he can either take me home or go to the hotel, either or, you know, I prefer hotel because then I don't worry about what's in your home. You know, I don't worry about that. But, I mean, it takes a major trust factor to have someone take you to their home anyways. So, that will be a different ballgame when that happens. This is the day it's going to be longer, and there's probably going to be sex. So, oh yeah, I'll probably end up having to tell my mom. And it's going to be, it's gonna be like jumping over the Empire State Building. Jumping over it. That's what I meant, jumping over it. It's gonna be like slaying a dragon. Yeah. That's gonna be like slaying a dragon. That's gonna be probably the worst night of my life. You know, unless she's ready for it by then. Unless she's like so used to all this and she's just like ready. Maybe she'll just be like, okay, which would be great. She's like, And she's, like, ready and not shocked by a great. It's never like that. Never. So this isn't the end of all this. This is gonna be my life for a little while. Fucking hate it. Fucking hate this. This is fucked up. So, anyhow, the stakes are that much higher when I pass the driver's test. I have to pass that test. I want to pass it first try. If I don't, then it's going to be really a hard pill for me to swallow. Because I had to restudy and wait 15 more days. And it's a test that I have to pass. Especially if I do really bad on it, the pill's going to be really hard for me to swallow. Because it's a test I have to basically pass for my freedom. That's the way it is. I have to basically pass a test to gain my freedom. Or else I have no freedom as long as I don't pass that test. It's like, oh yeah, you're no good. I have no freedom. If I don't pass that test, I have no freedom. Because my dad's making me go for my mom for this stuff. So I have to pass that test for my freedom, for my own sake. If I really care about sex, hopefully I'll have my virginity broken, No, I'm going to be taking the test before I get my virginity. So it's like, if I really care about sex, I really care about all this, I really care about my boyfriends, I have to pass. For them. And for me. And for my freedom. Sad. That's the way it is. That's life. Sad. Life's unfair. Difficult. It's reality. It's the reality I'm faced with, man. And oh, well, the problem is a lot of kids did it a lot earlier, and I didn't because I got told all this negative stuff, and I, you know, got discouraged and everything, and I got, you know, I got told this. I got told that I couldn't do it, basically. Basically, I got told I couldn't do it because my parents couldn't afford driving lessons. So basically, I got the message that you can't do it. Just don't let anybody tell you that you can't do it, because look at me. I mean, I'm fucked, okay? I'm like, fucked here. All right, so anyhow, I do want to say before I go, what I think would help me a lot, with maybe everything, my life overall, although this is kind of like something that I haven't really taken up yet in a serious matter or whatever, but, I know one of my girlfriends is into, like, the alternative scene. And she's always telling me about how, because her mom's stricter than mine, because it's a good thing that I have her as a friend, because her mom's really strict. And it makes me realize that my mom is not as nearly as strict as her mom, so her mom's even stricter, so it's actually kind of good for me. Because then it helps me learn to appreciate what I've got and stuff, but I feel really bad for, okay, I mean, I'm always helping her and mentoring her and stuff like that. She's like, I think she's 16 right now, so she's like 3 years younger than me or something. Okay, 18, 17, yes, so 3 years. Okay. And her mom's real, I hope she doesn't see this. I hope her mom doesn't see this video or else I'm in trouble. But anyhow, okay, I'm in trouble. But I know the rules in her house are much more, because I know rules in her home were much more worse than here. I mean, when she turns 18, I don't know if I'm going to be hearing, yay, I'm liberated, or if it's going to be the same crap. This is most likely to be the same crap. I haven't really changed her. And I have gained some freedom. Not as much as I have liked to. Because I'm still dealing with my mom on a serious level. And it's not cool. This pop-up came up on my phone. About carrier settings. Okay, so basically my point. She's in the alternative scene. She really wants to look alternative and everything. And she brings it up and I try to be of help. There's not much I can do about it because basically she lives with parents that won't let her express herself or looks or anything. She can't look goth. Can't look emo. She can't look any of that. Her parents are like, no. You gotta look like this. That's her parents. My parents wouldn't do that to me. Not even my mom wouldn't do that to me. So anyhow, I've started to kind of, like, consider it myself because, I mean, I've been looking at a lot of, like, girls with alternative hairstyles and stuff because she talked about it, and I've been trying to help her with the look. I'm thinking of kind of, like, giving myself the look. I mean, not, like, completely, but, just kind of, like, doing it partially because I honestly think I would be much more at peace with myself if I were to kind of like express all the chaos that's going on here and in my life through my looks. I think I would be a lot more at peace with myself because, yeah, I think it would help me because a lot of things that I'm unhappy with, that I'm upset with, and I know that a lot of people think that I have a good mom. I agree. I get it. I understand, but I'm not a free individual. I don't have my freedom. I'm not really a free individual. So I think it'd be good, you know. I just think that it would help me come to peace with myself more because I'm, like, basically, you know, in the I haven't situation as far as sex goes, and, I was reading this one, I actually Googled how to deal with being a virgin, and I looked at this one article, the one that really stood out to me was Thoughts of a Virgin, that WordPress.com, and I read her article, Pros and Cons of Being a Virgin. Actually, the innocence and the purity thing bother me. That's not me. I'm a rocker girl. I'm heavy metal. Like, no. I'm too edgy for that shit. Okay, like, no. I'm gonna put this like innocence thing on me. Come on. That's something that always bothered me about it. Songs like Sister Christian. No. Really. Come on. Oh man. Sister Christian. No. Okay, Cherry Pie by Warrant. Don't mind that. I really don't mind that. Because she was not portrayed like an angel, but every time Virgin's portrayed like an angel, it's so sick of it! It bothers me a lot. Okay. So anyhow, I don't need to get any more vocal about it. I'm going to give myself a sore throat. But anyhow, she lists all the pros and cons of being virgin. All the cons that she listed really speak to me. And I'm tired of living with it. Like, sometimes I feel like I don't even want to live because of this whole, like, loneliness thing and everything is, and this, like, the desire and the fantasies are so great, so monumental. And she was saying, when people talk about their sexual experiences, like, you're just left to fantasize about great sex, it's like, really? You know, yeah. I've been dealing with that for how many years? I waited to turn 18. I paid my dues. So, the longer I wait, I'm only hurting myself. But the people around me are hurting me. So, it's like if the people around me aren't getting hurt, I'm hurting myself, and then the people around me are getting hurt, and I'm doing myself better by not being rich. Yeah. Well, it's a double standard. Oh, I've seen the double standard thing about gender, man versus woman, how sex is looked at and portrayed on television everywhere so many times, and that is not okay. That is not okay, man. That is not okay. Let me repeat. Not. N-O-T. Not okay. And not okay. You know. Fed up with it. But anyhow. There's all these cons she listed being virgin. I experienced every single one of them. All that shit she listed. Oh yeah. I do. And I'm never gonna wear it as a, oh, it's a badge to be proud of. Oh, people look. I'm never gonna. I'm not gonna do that as a fucking loner in school. I'm never gonna be, like, proud of it. Like, wear it as a badge to be proud. Like, no. 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 I refuse to. No. Just no. Just no. I'm not gonna say shut up, but I mean, just no. That's. I'm sorry. I mean, it'll be a healthy change in my life for a lot of reasons. The change isn't so healthy if you catch an STD or get pregnant. Yeah, sure. I know. Oh, yeah. I know. That's why I'm forcing myself to wait for somebody who's clean. Even that's hard work. Yeah. And then I wait for someone that I love. Oh, I'm so tired of hearing it. Shut up. You do need trust. Girl and catch AIDS, so you do need trust. Yes, you do need an element of trust, no matter what. I mean, you'll always need an element of trust, no matter what, okay? Trust is very important to the structure of lovemaking. But, yeah. And this whole thing about, oh, it has to be someone you love. Like, I'm just, oh my God, would you please talk to the wall over there? You know, I got preached with that garbage and no. As long as I can feel that trust there, that's good. You know, I don't have to be like head over heels in love with the person. I have to be like, oh my God, he's such a good guy. I don't have to do that. No. Bitch, no. Like, no. Like, no. Like, no. I don't think like that, and I never will think like that again, because my first crush went out horrible. Very bad experience. Okay? So anyhow, on the other note, I'm considering going alternative style a little bit more. I mean, I already wear rock t-shirts. I already would consider myself pretty alternative, but, you know, Last time I dyed my hair, I was 13 years old. But I don't know. I'm not considering doing anything major with my looks right now. But anyhow, I am considering, well, money is a big thing for me right now. Like, money won't be such a big thing when I'm in college again, because there's grants and everything and all that, and financial aid, better work study, all that comes active again. That's only if I keep up good grades, and some of my classes next year might be harder. So, I don't know. I've been getting good grades all along. I mean, anyhow, I'm gonna worry about it unless that happens. But okay, so money is the big thing right now. But I have some stuff in my house alone. I already have some stuff to look more alternative if I wanted to. I have scarves. I have jewelry and accessories. I already have some stuff that I could look more alternative if I want to. But I really want to do something with the hair. I like those hair extensions. They don't cost that much. Those things that you put your hair. The clip's kind of a pain in the ass. You know, honestly, I like to get some temporary dye and just maybe dye like a little strip of it or some shit. I don't know. I'm going to be careful because I don't want to, like, make it look silly or anything. I always like sexy as far as my look goes. I don't want to make it look too silly, but I think it would be kind of a cool thing for me to go a little more alternative style. Just, I don't want to completely lose myself in it, but, I you know, just to go a little bit more, like, just do that a little bit. Just kind of do that. I think that would be good because I think it would be a good way of coming as peace at myself and kind of, like, expressing myself and outside appearance and stuff. And I'm gonna get lookers and all that. I don't know. You know, I don't want it to look silly, though. I want to make sure that it's sexy and, or that it's cute enough to look sexy. I don't want it to look silly. Like, a lot of people look silly. And there's a lot of really sexy alternative girls anyway, so every time I've done it in the past, it always looks silly. But I'm considering doing it now because I have a significant amount of feelings that I'm holding on to. I have a certain amount of, I hate to say, like, an excuse to do it, but I have, like, you know, like, I have a reason to do it. I hate to say that. It's like, you know, an excuse to do it or a reason to do it. And, well, you know, I'm feeling very angry and pissed off right now. I hate to say that's the reason I'm doing it, too, but I don't know what to do it because of the fact that I feel that it would kind of like maybe show a more rebellious side possibly if I do it right, and that's what I want to show because I'm feeling these feelings of like, oh, you know, just want to break glass. Like, you just want to, like, you know, just, like, this, like, you know, feeling just, like, trapped. You're holding on, like, these demons or whatever, these really, like, strong emotions. Especially with the one about my virginity. Very strong, strong, heavy emotions. So I think that'd be good. But, I mean, money is a big issue right now. So I don't know how far I'm going to be able to go with it. I don't know if I'm even going to be able to look at it. I may just say, oh, just take it right off, you know. Because, like, I'm very simplistic right now, you know, with my looks. I'm very simplistic pretty much, but nothing wild and crazy, but I don't know. I want it to look sexy, though. I'm always about sexy. I've tried looking at it before a couple of times, and it looks silly. I don't want it to look silly. Like, oh, rainbows, no. Unicorn, oh, no. Like, no. Yeah, I want it to look sexy, okay? You know what I'm saying. I'm an edgy person, so I want it to look edgy anyway, so... I think y'all know what I'm talking about. I don't want to look really like... I mean, yeah... I may think to myself that I look silly 1 minute, and I look in the mirror and be like, oh, this is really sexy. So, I don't know. I don't know. Just... It would be a nice thing for me to do, because it would probably clear out the strong emotions I have and probably help me with some of the anger that I'm dealing with right now, because I'm dealing with anger issues at the moment, because... And by the way, the news has been so stressful. Man, what's going on right now? Shit. The dating conflict, yeah, it's been so stressful. The thing that's the most stressful is the feelings about my virginity. That's what's the most stressful. But anyhow, I'm gonna stop broadcasting now. I hope I can put this up on YouTube.